My name is Ali Dennis. I work for CC Tech as a software developer, and I'd like to take you through the digital children attendance tracking platform. Let's get started. To download the mobile application, you require an Android device like this one. So if you have an Android device, you'll be able to download the application to your phone. And you can head to the Play Store and search for attendance tracker. So type attendance tracker. Install the one that's written CC Tech Team. So I already have it installed on my phone, so I won't install it again, but it's as easy as pressing the install button, and it's going to take about a minute to install. So I'm going straight to logging into the application. So as a teacher, to be able to mark attendance for your school and your students, you require to logging into the application. So as you can see on this application, we have the school code or the MS code for your school and the password. And those are the credentials that we're going to be using to log in. So I'll type the school code for my school. And the password. And now I'm logged in. So we have the second section of the mobile application, which is the My School section, at the very bottom of the screen, next to attendance. So when you click on My School, we have the student section, which showcases the number of students in our school, Nawawi. The name of the school is shown at the very top section of the page. And then it says we have 38 boys in this school, 6 girls, and a total of 44 students. So one of the features that we can do under the student section is to add or edit a student. So I'll click on this button that says add or edit students. And on this page, we're able to add students to different classes. On the top right, we have the three lines, which help us to filter between, or rather to change from one class to another. So maybe we can go to class 4A and class 1A, and this enables us to add students to the respective class. In our case, we're going to be adding this student to class 5A. And to add a student, you go, there's a plus button at the bottom right of the mobile application. And when you click on it, you get a list of information that you need to add in order to add a new student. So in our case, under first name, I'll put Mel. And under that last name, I'll put Fain, which is also one of our colleagues at CC Tech. And we'll add an admission number. In this case, we'll use a dummy number for presentation purposes. And then I will select the gender, which is either female or male. And then we'll select the date of birth. So we can choose the student's date of birth and select which class we want to add them in, which automatically comes prefilled as 5A. And then if the student has any special needs, such as visual impairments, hearing impairments, physical disabilities, or any learning disabilities or difficulties, in our case, we can say none, press OK. Then we can select the student status, if they are, in any case, a refugee, asylum seekers, or IDPs, or none of the given reasons. So maybe we can choose none. And the guardian status, if the student has both parents, a single parent, or in any other case. So maybe in this case, we can say both parents. It's okay. And to add a student, we click on the Add Student button at the very bottom of the list of things to populate. And when you click on Add Student, We now have a new student in our classroom. As you can see, we had 6 students and now we have 7. And at the bottom of the list, we have Melfane, our new student, added to this classroom. Okay. And the beauty of this application is that this information is directly synchronized to the ministry's dashboard. And if we go and check the ministry's dashboard right now, and this is the system from the ministry, and we are logged in for our school, Nawawi, as showcased also in our mobile application. And on the ministry's dashboard, we have an overview of the different classes that we have, the students, the teachers, and the attendance taking report. So we'll go to the student section, and under student enrollment, we expect to see our newly added student in class 5. So I will filter and scroll down to class 5 just to check. And as you can see on the ministry's dashboard, our new student that has been added is shown on our list, Mel, and we have an MS code for them, and the school that they've been added to, and some additional information about the student. So what we can do now is head back to the mobile application and take attendance for the newly added student. So again, on the bottom section of the app, we can go to the attendance section and go to the class that our student has been added, which is 5A. And now we have this student in our list. So maybe we'll take attendance for a previous date that we hadn't taken. So maybe on the 20th. And for the 20th, maybe we'll just say that our new student Mel is the student that was present in class for that day. So I'll click on the circle, red circle on the right, and it shows the blue check mark saying that actually our student is present, and then click on the submit button. And then it's going to ask me, do I want to take attendance of class 5A with 6 students absent? And I'll say yes. And again, we get a short attendance report of the status of the daily attendance for this day. So 1 student present, 6 students absent. So the beauty of this is that when we go to the ministry system, we expect to see the same information on the ministry system side. So on the left side of the ministry system, we'll go to attendance and select the student attendance section. And we will select for our class 5A, on the date of the 20th that we've taken attendance for on the mobile app. Press on get data. And as you can see, the system tells us that 6 students were absent and 1 student is present. And this is showcased by this green check mark on the web dashboard. And the red ones show the absent students. So we have the 6 red buttons showing the students that are absent, and we have 1 green button showcasing the present student, which is Mel, the new student that we have added. And so basically that shows that we are able to add new students through the mobile application, and these new students will show on the ministry's dashboard, as well as we are able to take attendance for students through the mobile application, and this will show on the ministry's dashboard as well.